Hello Gundam fans, this is Brom92, and today I'll be looking at the 1-in-100 Master Grade Tallgeese 3 from Dragon Momoko, and this model was purchased at Gundam Central. So, it's essentially the Bandai Tallgeese mold with parts to make it into the Tallgeese 3. We got a new head. Well, not a whole new head, the top and the front is new, and the shoulders. Initially, I thought it was just the rim of the shoulders, but after looking at it, there's actually detail in there in the inner shoulder, which wasn't on the original. I'll show later. Other than that, it's a recolor of the existing Tallgeese. Now, I have gone ahead and glued. I didn't put a lot of glue, just enough to keep the head on because. Well, that's okay, whatever. But the top of the head, it pegs in back here into the normal head, and it doesn't like to stay. So I just put a little bit of glue to keep it there. It's a lot easier than having me fiddle around with it for the whole review. The shoulder armor is, it sometimes comes off, but it's actually kind of sturdy. And some of the joints are a little loose, like the arms come off a little too easily at the shoulder end down here. And the hands way too easily. Getting deja vu from a 1-in-100 no grade 00 knockoffs I reviewed years ago. These parts here. Now, in the original, they're supposed to peg in here and in the skirt armor, but they is either one or the other. You can't get both, and I don't know why. Because I can take this ball thing and peg it in there, but then if I try to peg into here, it doesn't work. It just doesn't work. So I just keep it like that. Now, it also has a little bit of a problem standing up. The ball joints and the feet are kind of loose. And you can, if you mess with him, get him to stand. It's actually easier with the accessories, believe it or not. You can kind of distribute the weight. Now, you also have a foil sticker sheet, which you don't actually need because these are for the Tallgeese 1 and the Tallgeese 2, which they did release. Like before the Tallgeese 3, so we don't need these. However, a very nice sheet of water slide decals, which I am definitely going to use, because I do have an idea to paint this guy, which is why I didn't want to put a lot of glue on him, if any at all, just so I could actually, like, take him apart and paint him. And let's look at that head sculpt. It is rather nice. It definitely looks like the Tallgeese. You got the opening cockpit. And no pilot. They always omit the pilots within the Dragon Momoko line, and I just don't know why. What's the point? Like, if you're gonna take the mold, it is modified, but still, if you're gonna take a Bandai mold, what's the difference? Go the whole 9 yards, right? I don't know. It's kind of weird to me. So, aside from what I've already mentioned, it looks good. It has the nice, crisp panel lines. And it does go together rather well, like for the rest of the body, aside from some of the new pieces like the head. But overall, it looks good. Now, even though the head can be a pain in the butt, it still goes up and down, and it will rotate. And the arms can go forward and back, and up and down the torso, and rotate. And they'll go out about that far. The shoulder armor definitely does hinder it. Rotate below the shoulder. Double-jointed elbow. Ball-jointed wrist. Thumb. It's all ball joint. It has all the interchangeable fingers from the wing kits that we've already seen. You have the stomach joint, which is pretty free, and the waist swivel. And then the legs will go forward and a little back out. And like I said, these don't want to stay on, unfortunately. Nice double-jointed knee bend. And the foot goes forward and back, side to side, rotates. And you got the extra joint for the actual, like, separate from the ankle. So another ball joint there. So it's a, and these parts sometimes come off. So it does have the articulation, just like the original. And then we have the thrusters on the back, which, and there goes that arm. Yeah, like I said, those arm joints. So the thrusters can go. go up and down at the base, and then up and down at the thruster. And then you can also move the fin here and open them up, which it's a little hard to do sometimes, to open the top parts up too. It's a whole mechanism. And then you have the thrusters on the inside. Well, at least it does stay open though. Although I had problems with the original too, so it did not carry over well to this one. Considering, like I said, the original wasn't the easiest to get to open, like, automatically with the gear system. So articulation's fine, if you can get them to stand. It's just as good, as the original. Now, this is where things start to get different, because the accessories are completely different from the Tallgeese 1 and Tallgeese 2. First off, we got the shield, which is all molded in colored plastic, and you still have the beam saber handles, and you have two clear pink beams, which do not want to fit. This is the first time I've tried, and gonna have to whittle the wind the hole. Definitely. That's annoying. Get out. So that's a bit annoying, but they do fit onto this rather nicely, this little clip here. And you have the handle, which can swivel and move in and out. And then the joint, which polycap in here, not that good, unfortunately, but it does have the swivel and the one up here. And it works just like the, if the ball joint would stay, it'd be nice. It works just like the original Tallgeese, where you take the little flaps here and open them up. And you got the polycap. Which, these ones actually work rather well, which is a good thing. Unfortunately, like I said, this one here does not like to stay. So you can have it hold the shield, which is probably a good idea. Since it doesn't like to, this ball joint does not like to support the weight of the shield. But you can have it there. And of course, you got the little tip of the heat rod, which you do have the entire thing right here. It's basically from the Epion, because I think they did release the Epion, which was a full knockoff, I think. Just pop that in there. And it does exactly the same thing. You can push everything down so that it doesn't move, and it's one straight rod, or just pull it out a bit, and then it can curl. And then you can just connect it into the joint. And then you have the heat rod, or this is possibly my favorite thing out of the kit, the clear orange variant. So this is when it's activated, and it's gonna just melt an enemy mobile suit. It's all clear orange, given the little indents, even the different color pieces there. Little circles are all clear. So you hook this up. And you got a much different look, which I like. This doesn't even look good on the Epion, because it did the same thing. I'm pretty sure it did the same thing. So that's pretty neat. So I had to get back on this, take a look at it. That's cool. That is neat. That alone, I think, makes this kit worth it. But of course, we also have, got to take this off, it's gonna fall off. We have the Mega Beam Launcher. Now this thing gave me problems. Now first off, all the little hosing. Yeah, you might want to glue that. Unfortunately, they're little teeny pegs, and they don't like to hold. So just a little dab of glue to keep them in place. And yeah, it's a completely new piece, kind of like the shield. This thing rotates. I don't know why, but it does. It's a lot like Exia's Gian sword, where you have the handle which can come out, so it can use it easier. It's got a groove to fit into the holding hands with the peg. And then we come to this. This thing gave me no end of trouble, and I finally figured out why. I had to carve this part open to get this joint in here. and then glue it shut. And I figured out why. The original Tallgeese I have, this is actually a lot smaller. Maybe it's just my kit, but mine came with two of these, because the other one is in this shield. That's what it's supposed to be for, the shield connector. But instead of coming with the smaller joint, it came with another one from the shield. So I had to use it. And it doesn't work. It's too big. So hopefully other people get the right size. If not, you're going to have to modify it or figure something that I didn't. But it does have quite a few joints in it when you get it working. And I really like this thing now. In this mode, I think it's just... it fires like a beam rifle. But then it has the extending mode. Now, the cool thing is, you can't open it until you extend the barrel tip. And then it unlocks. Because the little part right here will peg into a hole inside, right in the back. So now, you can extend it. And now it's in its mega beam launcher mode. And it's pretty long. Now that's cool, but they give you an effect part, which is custom made for this Mega Beam Launcher. It's not something from like the Hino Gundam or something like that, because this part here, it is a little tricky to do, but this is going to go into that hole I mentioned, which locked the cannon in place initially. So you get that into the hole. I'm hoping I can do this. Okay. And then these pegs in here, there's some holes right up here. And they will peg into there, and into there. And now, that is freaking awesome. Look at that. Cool energy effect. It's building up the energy ready to fire. I like that a lot. And getting this guy to hold it is another story. Because like I said, these parts, see, and I have to have this up all the way. It pushes the shoulder armor up. A little annoying. But I'm going to try it anyways for everybody. So I think what I'll do is I'll put this on to the hand. So it has the indent. So it goes over the finger, like that. That's a pretty solid connection. Well, it usually is, as it comes out. It's a solid connection, pops out. Anyways. Okay. Now that we have that on there, gonna try being the main word, to have this hold. Just gonna extend that joint. I'm trying to figure out where the heck that hole is. Oh god, it's all the way back there. There we go. Now cover your Leo face. They need to make a Leo master grade. I mean, come on, it's right there. It's there in the mold. Give it to us, yo. Let's see if I can get the shield back on. There. It is heavy, that's for sure. But that is the Tallgeese 3 with all of its accessories. And it does look pretty good. Look at that heat rod, all ready to go. Beam cannon, all charged up. I like it. I really do like the accessories. They're very cool. But they're a pain in the butt to get to work, right? Like I said, as long as you have the smaller joint in your kit, you'll be fine. But if you have this one, you're going to have to modify the joint to get it to work right. Hopefully it'll be okay. But I had a problem with it, and it is a little tricky to get everything attached. Once you figure out the way to do it, it'll work, and it looks really good. It's just, you have to take some time, which is the main, kind of like the name of the game with these kind of kits. But I still like the accessories. Now, let's compare this guy, of course, to the Tallgeese 1. The Bandai version. And yeah, you can see it is the same mold. Just different head, different shoulder pieces. It's the same shoulder, essentially, and different accessories. And of course, because it has the heat rod and it was the previous unit for what's his face? The Epion. See, that heat rod would look really good with the Epion. Yes. Get a further away shot. Yep. So that is the Dragon Momoko Tallgeese 3. I like it. Not as much as I was hoping to, because it does have issues, but I think once I glue certain things, and I do have an idea for a paint scheme for this kit, I'll probably like it a lot more. Like I said, there are parts you really should glue. I know the mileage varies on knockoff third-party kits, so your kit might be okay. You might not have to glue it, but I still suggest it. I like the accessories. Once again, you gotta fiddle around with them. Love the clear heat rod. Love the cannon. Yeah, get it all put together. So it is a nice kit, but you have to work at it to make it, like, actually nice. So that's about it, and I'll see you at the next review.